There's a lot of invertebrate animals within that, which the botanists and so on, the biologists and we.
A long blade, sometimes with two handles, and they do that action. But you could really see that that could endure for a long time in the weather, couldn't it? Isn't it? It's extremely dense and tight. That was a real professional bit there, John Morton.
Yeah.
Look at the firmness and how it could throw off the water, the angle of it.
One of the key roles of the Wildfowl and Wetlands Trust at Castle Espie is to celebrate the wildlife and landscape of Strangford Loch, one of the most important habitats in Europe, and defend it against the many pressures it faces. Of course, we are not alone in this enormous task. We work in partnership with many other organizations to better understand the loch and its wildlife, and to use this knowledge to manage and protect it. But equally important is helping people to understand the true value of this magnificent place and supporting local community projects. The area of mudflats you see from this observatory is one of the most important bird areas in Europe, regularly supporting over 20,000 birds in winter. This part of the shoreline is managed by WWT, an area of over 600 hectares, stretching over 6 kilometers from the Comber estuary to your left, right down to Ringneil Quay on the islands to your right. Winter is best to see birds such as Brent geese, widgeon, hooper swan, shell duck, golden plover, grey plover, dunlin, red shank and knot, which feed on the eelgrass, worms or shellfish of the mudflats. In the summertime, look out for terns. 3 species breed on the loch. Otters hunting along the shoreline and mullet, which swarm in the shallow water. In order to understand how the birds of the loch are changing, a team of counters, armed with binoculars and telescopes and up to 30 strong, count the whole of the loch at the same time each fortnight. This is a difficult job. Sometimes golden plovers can be in flocks of over 2,000, while curlews often feed alone and all have to be counted. Catching and ringing birds also help us to understand how many birds use the loch as a feeding station before flying on further. It also helps us to reveal the flyways which birds use when moving between Strangford Loch and their breeding sites. For the Brent Goose, this is a journey that takes them over Iceland and Greenland to breed in Canada. Our staff have followed the geese to understand more about what these incredible birds face on the journey and how to protect them and their habitats. This is also about understanding and meeting the needs of people who live on this flyway without affecting the geese. We have even exchanged children from schools around Comber with schools in Iceland as part of building these important links. Your support is vital to helping WWT to manage and promote a Strangford Loch that is healthy for both wildlife and people. By visiting Castle Espie or becoming a member of WWT, you are sharing our vision for this magical place and supporting the need to conserve the great sea loch that is Strangford. But you are also supporting efforts far from these shores that ensure birds survive to winter here again.